On? Are we on? As long? We're on. Well, I hope we're on because now we've launched into the stratosphere of the biggest star on Broadway.
Stop speaking so softly. Get the mic close to your mouth.
Oh, sorry.
Yes.
All right. Yeah. I overcompensate. What can I?
No,
say?
Not at all.
I am a hyperbole, but you are
I
one
love
of
it.
My favorite stars,
oh,
and
thank
you were
you.
In a play that's not on.
That's
anymore.
True.
Death Takes a Holiday. So.
Yeah.
Congratulations, Matt Cavenaugh.
Thank
for
you.
Best featured actor in a musical. Yeah. And I was listening to you last night on the DVD they sent me because I didn't
oh.
see it.
Oh, very
and
cool.
You were awesome.
Oh, thanks. Thank
you. What were the songs you had?
This is a coup that I was nominated because I was on stage maybe all of 7.5 minutes. I came on midway through. I sang this kick A song that Mr. Yeston wrote and really turns the story on its head. Which is called Eric's Reverie, or Eric's Lament. It's a soliloquy singing of how his friend died in the war.
I call it wonderful.
Cha-ching. I like that. But it was an incredible moment crafted by Maury, and I've loved his music forever,
yeah.
And get the chance to work with him is a real
thrill. I feel
like
I'm on the Titanic. You're holding on for dear life as the Drummondist nominee cocktail
Speaking
party.
Speaking of Maury Yeston shows.
Yes.
Titanic.
Which I saw seven times. Yes.
Seven times?
I've been following your career very actively. We met on the street a couple of times.
Yeah, I remember that. Yes, we did. Yes.
Who could forget, right? And you started off riding a bull.
I did.
Shirtless.
Yes, that was my beginning. That
and
is true.
And what was the name of that show?
That show was called Urban Cowboy. I bet you didn't see that one seven times.
No, I didn't. I did.
Yes, I don't know if you had the opportunity to see that one seven
times. No, just once. Unfortunately, but you've been in so many things. You were in the Harvey Weinstein, the Harvey Fire. Excuse me, Harvey. The Harvey Weinstein musical of the sea. He could have one. You don't know.
He could. Catered Affair.
Yes.
Yeah, I loved Catered Affair.
And
that
you
was,
were also in.
I'll help you out, Stephen. I did Grey Gardens as well.
Grey Gardens. I was just going to say that. It was
right.
I saw Christine Ebersole, and I forgot the title.
Yeah.
Oh.
Well. One could. Her performance was just incredible.
And you played the Marble Fawn. I remember that.
I was the Marble Fawn. Yes. Who I see around on the street still some days. Jerry.
The Marble Fawn?
Yes, Jerry.
He does exist?
Yes.
I thought he was a composite character.
He lives in Queens. He drives a cab a few days a week here in the city. And I think a little plug for Jerry. I think he's actually about to, he's been working on releasing part of his moment. Because he lived with Edith and Edie for years. And tons of history there.
That's
all
true.
Yeah. Oh, it's all very true. Yeah. And a super, super nice guy. The sweetest guy you'll ever meet. Great guy.
And I always wanted to tell you how wonderful I thought you were and how talented. And I said one day it would happen. And
even that day has come.
It's here
and
now.
I thank you, sir.
And it's all downhill from here, I'm sure.
For both of us.
Matt Cavenaugh. And listen. I hear Hollywood calling. Is that possible?
Oh, when it's always calling. You know, I'm putting them on hold, though. I'm a little busy. Sorry. I got to put you on hold.
Because you have that beautiful voice.
Oh, that's nice. That's nice. And speaking of, well, hey, you can come hear my beautiful voice with my wife's beautiful voice at Feinstein's.
Oh, we're going. We're covering.
Feinstein's on July 18th. We'll be there.
One night.
July 18th.
Who is your beautiful wife?
My beautiful wife, Jenny Powers. We'll be doing a show called Loving You. Isn't that sweet? Husband and wife team. Come on. You can't
I'm
get
so
any
jealous,
than
but
that.
I'll come.
Yes. But there's a lot of biting comedy in there, too. It's not all sweet and romantic. You know, we also have a bit of repartee. But yeah, no, it's Monday night, July 18th at Feinstein's.
What was it like working with Harvey Weinstein? I mean, Harvey Firestein.
Well, you know, Harvey Weinstein was actually a producer on West Side Story, so I have met Harvey. I met both Harveys. But
were you in West Side Story?
I was.
Oh, my
was.
God. And you played?
I played Tony in West Side Story.
Of course you did. I saw that. You were fabulous.
Seven times. Did you see that one seven times?
No, once.
Oh, just once.
I've seen it on television last night.
Oh, okay. Well, there you go.
Wishing you were in it, obviously.
Well,
you know. And Arthur Lawrence said on Theater Talk, before he died, he felt the story of West Side Story was really the unrequited love between Tony and
Riff.
I know. Who was played in the movie by?
Not a clue.
George Chakiris.
There you go.
No, or Russ Tamblyn, but not both.
See, I should know this, but not both. Yeah.
Yeah. See, I remember names and dates from like 50 years ago. it.
There's a pill
for
that.
You have, yeah, and I didn't take it. But I have to say, you were just stupendous in whatever it was you did. And I mean, and all those things you did. Excuse me, this isn't work. This is the Alzheimer's program today.
It started off so well.
Well, you know, and then you start forgetting
it
things.
It started off so well.
But I mean what I said.
Shall I get you another drink?
Okay, all right. Okay.
I'll get you another.
Okay, anyway, thank you so
thanks
much.
Thanks so much,
I can talk to you all day. Good luck at Weinstein.
Thank you, sir.
Weinstein?
Feinstein. There you go. Thanks, appreciate it.